amendment in the House on the status of implementation of the various recommendations, observations made by the standing committees in their reports within 6 months of their presentation in the House. In this context, the ministers made 388 statements regarding the status of implementation of the recommendations, observations contained in the reports of the standing committee. Putting questions is an important instrument in the hands of the members to scrutinize the functioning of the executive. In the 14 Lok Sabha, 6,218 start questions were listed, out of which 963 questions were answered orally. I tried my best to give opportunity to members belonging to different parties, large or small. Written replies to the remaining start questions, along with 60,419 unstart questions, were laid on the table. 14 half-an-hour discussions were also taken up. 5 short-notice questions were also answered. The 14 Lok Sabha enacted 258 legislation, including Right to Information Act, the National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, the Protection for Women from Domestic Violence Act, the Disaster Management Act, the Commission for Protection of Child Rights Act, the Scheduled Tribes and Other Traditional Forest Dwellers, Recognition of Forest Rights Act, the Unorganized Workers Social Security Act, the National Investigating Agency Act, and the Rehabilitation Resettlement Bill, 2009. Personally, it is a matter of great regret for me that we have not been able during my tenure to pass the Women's Reservation Bill, which to my mind would have gone a long way towards genuine and effective empowerment of 50% of our population. The Women's Reservation Bill has now been introduced in the Rajya Sabha during the 2008 budget session to ensure that the bill does not lapse with the dissolution 14 Lok Sabha. I am hopeful that all political parties will reach unanimity to build a clear consensus on the issue in the next Lok Sabha. Coming to the private members' business, 327 private members' bills were introduced during the 14 Lok Sabha. 9 private members' resolutions on important subjects were moved. During this Lok Sabha, 3,444 matters of urgent public importance were raised by the members after the question hour and at the end of the sitting for the day. Honourable members also raised 3,485 matters under Rule 377. As the presiding officer, I had humbly tried to allow members maximum opportunity to raise matters of importance. As a part of this approach, I allowed a larger number of matters under calling attention as compared to the number in the earlier Lok Sabha, which helped the members in getting response from the ministers to the matters raised by them. In fact, 115 calling attention matters were raised during this period. The ministers made 266 statements on various important subjects, which also include the statements made by the Honorable Prime Minister. In recognition of the right of the opposition to move adjournment motions on urgent issues, I tried my best to allow a number of them consistent with the provisions of the rules, many more than allowed earlier.